Hello, well, welcome to the Hong Kong Greek Gastronomy and Diet Festival. My name is Dimitris Bukhalis. I'm a visiting professor in the School of Hotel and Tourism Management. And I'd like to welcome you briefly to the Hong Kong Gastronomy and Diet Festival. I'd like to, first of all, say thank you to our Dean, Professor Kate Chon, who will be hosting and who will be chairing the session next, because it is a discussion we had with him when I arrived here 4 months ago, 5 months ago, and that's why we implemented that. And also, I'd like to say thank you to a lot of people who have been supporting us. You can see a lot of bottles in front of me, mainly from wine, from the winemakers of the North Greece, that they send us very nice wine for the tasting sessions. Olive oil that is coming from Mili Soyas and from the Sparta, the Mani region, and Kalamata. Costa Navarino, Navarino Icons on this side, that's also sent us a very nice products and olive oil, and also Bia Nissos from Tinos Island that we're going to be using for some of our workshops. Currently, we've got a lot of COVID restrictions, so started as an event that we'll do into face-to-face, had to move into hybrid and actually to online. And even we are in the same building with my dean and several other colleagues that you've seen very soon. We're all in different offices and we are keeping all the distances. I'd like to say thank you to the Greek National Tourism Organization and the Consulate of Greece in Hong Kong, and you'll hear from Mr. Katoulas in a minute, the Greek Chamber of Commerce of Hong Kong, Network, and the guys in Tripoli, Kostas, Sotiris, for hosting us today on the online platform, Navarino Island, Navarino Icons, and Costa Navarino for all their support, and you'll hear from Marina in a minute, Hellenic Fine Oils, Oleosophia, Nissos Beer, the winemakers of North Greece, Levant of Food Limited, who is the local importer of food in Hong Kong, who collaborates with Mevgal. And we also have the support of Safe Stories, Nutrilicious, and Slow Food of Hong Kong. And these are our sponsors and our supporters, and we very much like to thank them. Without further delay, I'd like to pass the floor to my dean, Professor Kate Chon, who is going to chair the first session. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Bouhalis. Welcome to Gastronomy and Diet Conference for Greece. In my conversation with Professor Bouhalis, it just came to our attention that in this part of the world, in Asia, of course, Greece is a country very well known for tourism, well known for its history, culture, religion, its language, but little known for its culinary art. Realize that it's a country with very rich culinary art and diet stretching over 4,000 years. We came with this idea that why don't we do this a conference about Greek food, gastronomy, and diet? And the Food and Wine Academy of the School of Hotel and Tourism Management at Hong Kong Polytechnic University has been seeking support from Consulate General in Hong Kong of Greece. And we came to today's conference. We are very pleased and privileged to have this conference with online participants from around the world. Also a large number of students and staff from our own school. So in this opening session, we have four distinguished speakers, and I want to introduce one at a time. The first speaker is a Deputy Minister of Tourism of Greece. We are so honored and privileged to have Ms. Sofia Zakharaki, who is the Deputy Minister of Tourism. She completed English language studies at National and Kapodistrian University of Athens, and also postgraduate studies in comparative pedagogy and administration of European Education Organization. Now she is the Deputy Minister of Tourism for Greece. And without further ado, I'd like to invite Ms. Zakharaki to give us her opening remark, please.
Dear Professor, thank you very much for today's invitation. And of course, Mr. Bouchalis, it's a great honor for me to be here among you, among the presence. Preferably, next time we'll meet in person. And I think that this is a great symbolism today of being able to resist, you know, even the impacts of COVID and still remain in contact, exchanging the basic messages and also very important input also from the country, our country here, who has been, of course, under a lot of strain during the past 2 years, but we're trying, as I said, to resist. And we're trying, of course, to convey the message that tourism has been working despite difficulties. And we have been trying to enrich this very important product here in Greece, the hospitality sector, with, of course, agrotourism and the very important and essential connection between primary production, the flavor, the scents that have been transcending time here in Greece, the olive, the wine, the cheese, the herbs, all the basic ingredients that we have been using in order to make the beer and make these products an ambassador for our country. And of course, what a nice ambassador that is to be able to savor all these products away from home. So thank you very much. And I would like to very warmly thank the organizers, of course, the consulate, all the sponsors, the Chamber of Commerce, the Greek Chamber of Commerce in Hong Kong, and all the sponsors who have been generous enough, of course, to send the products as the winemakers of Northern Greece. Maybe somebody would find it redundant for me to just add up to the history, to the rich history of the Greek products. And you know that it has been going back centuries. And there have been a lot of written records of all these journeys of the scents and flavors. But let me just take a minute to talk about what we're doing here in Greece, what we have been doing and what we will be doing as regards gastronomy, especially when it comes to the relation with the Ministry of Tourism that I have the honor of being the Deputy Minister. And of course, let me just say that we also have the wishes and the greetings of our Minister, Mr. Minister Vasilis Kikilias. So during the past year, we have been very, very happy and very honored to be trying to convey the message of this relation, as I said, of the primary sector, all the amazing Greek products with tourism, especially basing our efforts on wine. We have been organizing several congresses around Greece. The first was in Santorini, the beautiful island of Santorini, one of the first islands to be able to have wineries that also have a quality badge of the Ministry of Tourism, so people can visit them, they can enjoy the wine, they can enjoy the views, and also take back the products as ambassadors, as I said, of our beautiful country. Secondly, we have had one in Northern Greece, especially in Northern Western Greece, that is real need of our support with beautiful wineries in, as I said, in amazing landscapes. And we're continuing. We'll continue our effort in all 13 regions around Greece. But we do not stop there. We continue with a new law that we will also offer a quality badge in wineries, in cheese-making manufacturing places and in beer making places, so that more and more visitors can enrich their experience. And we know that when we're talking about tourism and hospitality, dear professor, I'm sure that your students in the wonderful school that you are working in, they know that it's all about experiences. It's all about savoring not only the sea and sun aspect of our country, but also the whole experience that we can offer here, and it's authentic and it's local. That's why we are placing more and more efforts in what we said before. We tried and we were successful in submitting our applications in UNESCO in creative cities. I don't know if you are familiar with this process. UNESCO has started a very important institution, the Creative Cities of Gastronomy, and our beautiful city of Thessaloniki in Northern Greece. Its winemakers are present here today, and really grateful for that. Was the successful candidate from Greece, and now it is listed in the category of the creative cities of gastronomy. And as I said before, we did not stop here either. In our the next tranche of money that will be given by the European Commission in order to tackle the impacts of the pandemic, what we call here the recovery fund, a very large amount will go to creating a special DMMO, a destination management product, as regards gastronomy, as regards trying to reinforce the branding and marketing techniques of our different regions via the help of the state during by this DMMO, and of course the essential help of the private sector. I wanted to share these thoughts today because I'm very certain, and I'm very certain that you will be talking about the Greek products, this history of time, but I would like to make this contribution as to what we're doing today and what we will be doing tomorrow, because we cherish the past. This is why we are taking this trail down to now, and the Greek government will, you know, do their utmost in order to better prepare for this connection between, as I said before, the products and tourism, and of course the secondary sector. And let me end this contribution by really wishing that we will welcome you here, oral friends from Hong Kong, very soon when, you know, the impacts of the pandemic and then restrictions recede. And we would like to taste here together on a Greek table in a Greek taverna or a Greek restaurant with a Greek with a glass of white wine and these amazing quality products very soon. So let this gastronomy conference be a start of getting back to the new normal and getting back to traveling, and of course all these restrictions disappearing very soon. Again, I would like to thank you for this very kind invitation, and I wish you the best of luck with today's conference.
Thank you very much, Minister. Your speech is very inspirational, and I cannot wait to go back to Greece. As you said exactly, I want to experience the tourism after COVID-19 in Greece. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Our next speaker is Ms. Marina Papasoni from Costa Navarino and Navarino Icons. Marina is Director General, Business Development and Corporate Affairs, and board member of TEMES SA, and developers of Costa Navarino. She is responsible for brand and concept development, marketing, and PR strategy for TEMES SA. Marina is also Managing Director of Greca Icons SA, a leading exporter of luxury food products. She is also board member of Discover Greek Culture SA, Stadium 2020 SA, the Democracy and Culture Foundation, and sits on the steering committee of Navarino Environmental Observatory, known as NEO. Previously, she held executive positions at Intracom Holdings and Adair Such and Such. Marina graduated from Emerson College in Boston, United States, with an MA in Political Communication and Marketing. Having visited more than 73 countries and regions and 800 cities, including Hong Kong, where we met each other first time, Marina is also travel writer for CNN Travel. So we are very pleased to have Ms. Marina Papasoni with us. Please.
Thank you very much, Professor Cho, and thank you for the invitation, Professor Bouhalis. And it's a great honor to be here among distinguished speakers such as the Minister and the Consul General. First of all, I have to say that I had the privilege of visiting Hong Kong PolyU and Professor Cho. And so the amazing work that they're doing there in the university and the very unique concept that he introduced, I think first time in the world, combining a university with a hotel, which is one of the two, three best hotels in Hong Kong, Icons. So I was really impressed and honored that here today that I can, you know, speak with you. Let me share a presentation with you. Oops, One second. Can you see me?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Allow me to show you, to say a few words about Costa Navarino. Costa Navarino is a destination, a prime sustainable destination in southwest Peloponnese with an easy access from Athens, 2 hours, and a 30-minute access from Kalamata International Airport, which is an airport that connects with more than 35 European cities and other cities around the world. It's a destination consisting of 5 different completing and not competing areas, exceeding in more than 1,000 hectares. It has 4 hotels, houses and villas for sale, and a significant investment in sports with 4 golf courses, a Muratoglou tennis court. I would like to say that very recently, actually last week, we announced also a Mandarin Oriental, which is a brand based in Hong Kong, opening in 2023 in Costa Navarino. A month ago, a W Costa Navarino, first time both of them in Greece. And we do have also 2 more hotels, the Westin and the Romanos. In total, though, upon completion of all our investments, the investment will exceed 2.5 billion, including the investment in real estate. And we will have more than 11 hotels, golf courses, and real estate. So it's a significant, one of the biggest private investments in Greece. It was born by the vision of one man, Captain Vasilis Kostantakopoulos, who his main and the company's primary or initial business was shipping, one of the 3rd biggest container shipping companies in the world, listed in the New York Stock Exchange. But he always wanted to give something back to his homeland, the land that he was born, which is Messenia, where we are investing. So he, back in the early, envisioned this dream of developing a sustainable destination for people from all over the world to come and visit what we think is a very beautiful place, combining history, authenticity, with high-end infrastructure for people to enjoy. Our vision was and is to establish Costa Navarino and Messenia as a paradigm destination for people not only to visit, but also to live there, either as a second home or as a permanent home. And in the center of our philosophy is a genuine desire to promote, but at the same time, protect and preserve the natural beauty and heritage. Allow me to show you a short video about Costa Navarino.
Grandfather, I dreamt I went on a journey to a land at the edge of the world.
With my loyal crew, we explored an ancient land with mysterious structures.
We called this land Messenia
by the name Costa Navarino.
Although we were strangers, the land was kind to us.
We called it Messenia.
Hospitality.
And the days flowed past us like a river.
We knew the gods watched over us. I could see that this land had been protected, loved,
so that it would live on for a thousand years.
For a thousand years. And when I woke up...
And when I awoke, Grandfather,
I knew that I had finally made it home.
Idea about Costa Navarino and going now to gastronomy and tourism. From the beginning of our development, we had a very clear vision that those two, gastronomy and tourism, goes hand in hand together. The World Tourism Organization says that gastronomy is the number 3 reason for traveling. And only last year, the World Food and Tourism Association said that 93 of all travelers are now considered food travelers, which means obviously that they're not food travelers because they visited a restaurant, but they're food travelers because they had one culinary experience, at least during the trip. We have three pillars in focusing in gastronomy and tourism. The one is supporting primary production, and I will tell you some things that we're doing either as Temes Costa Navarino or with our foundation, Captain Vasilis Kostadakopoulos and Carmen Foundation, or with Navarino Icons. We use products, we've said about Navarino Icons, as a tool for destination promotion. And at the same time, as the minister said before, we develop unique and authentic gastronomy experiences because we believe that the only way to make people part of the land is to include them in the experiences that we are offering as Greece, Messenia, and Costa Navarino. We are investing a lot as a foundation and as Costa Navarino in reviving, first of all crops. Crops that they have been forgotten, crops that they were predominant in Greece in the past years. And at the same time, we have invested a lot in training farmers in sustainable farming and restaurants in reviving recipes, again, forgotten through the years from the grandmothers and the grand-grandmothers. More than 1,500 farmers and local restaurants has participated in the extensive seminars that we are doing in Messenia in order to upgrade the product either in a primary level or the experience that our guests are having in throughout the restaurants of Messenia. Professor Buhal said before about Navarino Icons. You can find Navarino Icons in City Super in Hong Kong. I hope that you will increase a bit our sales there. We have an excellent cooperation for the past 5 years. Navarino Icons, as well as our second line, Tria, has been an ambassador of Greece, Messenia, and Costa Navarino for the past over 10 years. We have been communicating and creating experiences and memories with more than 10, 15 million people around the world. Our products are found in business and first class of Aegean, of course, Lufthansa, Air France, Saudi Airlines, as well as predominant shops at City Super, as I said before, Harrods, Dean and DeLuca, Whole Foods, and around the world. And this gives an opportunity for people that are visiting Greece, are visiting Messenia and Costa Navarino, to take some of the flavors, as the minister said before, back home in their country and keep the memory alive. Finally, experiences is our key driver to make people part of our land. And we have invested in a program called Messenia Authenticity. The core of this program is gastronomy. Let me give you an example. We have our guests can go to local homes with local women, pick up vegetables from the gardens, cook together and eat as a family, as guests of their family house. We have olive and wine harvesting in October and August, where people not only can harvest the trees, but goes in the mill, see how the whole process is and produce their own olives and wine. We have a lot of experiences, as I said before, in gastronomy. I will show one more, not to exceed the time frame that I was given, farm to table. This is another experience that we have where children as well as adults can understand the whole process where the vegetables come from. I will show you a short video and then I'm happy for any discussion later. Thank you very much. Be part of our story in Costa Navarino and Navarino Icons. Thank you for the opportunity to speak today.
Thank you much. Yes, your presentation is very rich and then definitely raises our appetite for Greek food. And we cannot wait to go back to Greece and especially to Costa Navarino. The next speaker is somebody I met on several occasions in Hong Kong, the Consul General of Greece, Mr. Konstantinos Katoulos, is a graduate of Law School of Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. Upon graduation, he was admitted to Diplomatic Academy of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. He has served in the Greek diplomatic mission in Montenegro, which is in Uruguay, also Portugal, in the Department for the External Relations of the EU, Desk Office for Relations of the EU with Asia, Africa, Latin America, EU Enlargement. He speaks multiple languages such as English, French, Spanish, and Portuguese on top of Greek. So we are very happy to have Consul General Katoulos with us. Consul General.
Thank you very much, Professor Chon. Thank you very much for the invitation today. I'm very proud to be part of the Greek Gastronomy and Diet Festival from ancient times to modern Mediterranean well-being philosophy. I would very much like to thank Professor Dimitrios Bouchalis for being the mastermind behind the organization of the online conference today and of course of the festival, the three-month festival that we follow. I would like also to thank Chair and Professor Kay Chong, Dean of the Hotel and School Tourism Management of Hong Kong Polytechnic University and Hong Kong Polytechnic University for making it possible and for hosting the online conference today and the festival that will follow. Of course, I would like to thank the National Organization of Greece for its participation and its contribution to today's conference and to the festival. As well, a special thanks, of course, to the Deputy Minister of Tourism, Mrs. Sofia Zaharaki, for honoring us today with participation in our online conference. This festival would not be possible if it wasn't for our sponsors, of course. I would like to mention some of them. Maybe I will forget some. I hope they can forgive me. I'm talking about the Association of Wine Producers of Northern Greece, I'm talking about the Hotel Costa Navarino, Nistos Craft Beer, Mili Soyas, and Levant Food. I would also like to thank the Greek Chamber of Commerce, and of course, the students of the esteemed School of Hotel School and Tourism Management of Hong Kong, PolyU, for being part of this festival the following 3 months. This festival will give them a chance to acquaint themselves better with Greek gastronomy and Greek culture, and will contribute to the internationalization of their studies. Today's, ladies and gentlemen, today's conference is going to be dedicated to the three sessions, which are essentially the products. We have the ambassadors of our export agricultural industry. I'm talking about, of course, olive oil and oil. I'm talking about cheese and dairy products, as is Veta, Graviera, Xinotiri, Lavotiri, and of course, I'm talking about wine, Greek wines and beers. This online today's festival is part of the three-month festival that will follow and that will also include a series of four main workshops where specialists will give an in-depth analysis of our main products, of some of the main aspects of Greek gastronomy and diet. It will also include lunch buffets served with Greek food, a series of them, and two official dinners. All of this, of course, pending to be confirmed on the evolution of the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic here in Hong Kong. Ladies and gentlemen, I wouldn't want to omit a reference to my city because just recently, November 2021, Thessaloniki was designated as UNESCO Creative City for Gastronomy. I'm very proud for this great distinction, and I hope that this distinction will bring more people in our country, in Thessaloniki, to be able to taste firsthand Greek products and Greek gastronomy. From my point of view, this festival, and I'm coming to the things, to some remarks I would like to make concerning our presence here, Greek presence here in Hong Kong. This festival presents us with a unique opportunity to create the propitious ecosystem that will enhance synergies and will create more cooperation opportunities between Hong Kong and Greece. During my stay here the last 2 years and a half, I have identified 5 sectors where more synergies and more cooperation could be sought. First of all, investments. Ladies and gentlemen, Greece has turned the corner from a 10-year debt crisis. It has recovered and is back on the track of sustainable growth. According to the last estimates of the European Commission, our growth rate for 2021 is estimated at 8.5% of GDP, and 2022 will be almost 5% of GDP. The current government is very, very keen on creating the necessary condition for attracting more FDI to Greece. The Consulate General of Greece, along with the Greek Chamber of Commerce here in Hong Kong, is currently working towards this direction as well. The second sector where more things could be done and there's ample space for improving is tourism. I would like to say that despite the ongoing pandemic, COVID-19 pandemic during the last 2 years, due to the concerted efforts of the current leadership of Ministry of Tourism, we have been able to strike a right balance between economic development and the restrictions that we have to take for the prevention of COVID-19. I think and I hope that this festival can open the door for more people to come to Greece, for more people to be able to taste firsthand the Greek gastronomy and the Greek delicacies that you will be able to taste in the next 3 weeks as part of our festival. Thirdly, the trade volume. We have to do much more to increase the trade volume between Greece and Hong Kong and to bring many more Greek products here in Hong Kong and in Hong Kong supermarkets, and maybe get a share of the Chinese, of the Hong Kong market, of the Hong Kong market here. Fourthly, is the academic cooperation. We could seek an agreement that will enhance cooperation between Greek universities and the universities here in Hong Kong. And of course, as part of that, we should seek agreements on student exchange programs as well. Lastly, but not least, the culture. Cultural sector is a sector that we should seek to increase cooperation. And maybe when COVID-19 pandemic is over and we come back to some kind of normalcy, we will be able to host here, with the cooperation of existing institutions here and a Greek museum, maybe a cooperation to bring an exhibition here with Greek artifacts. Thank you very, very much, and I wish all success to today's conference and to the 3-month festival that will follow. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Consul General. Now we want to have Mr. Dimitris Frangakis. We are very privileged to have the Secretary General of Greek National Tourism Organization with us. Mr. Frangakis holds a master's degree in law and political science from University of Athens and a BA in philosophy from Athens School of Philosophy. He also maintains his own tourism business, speaks fluent English and very good Italian. So we want to invite Mr. Frangakis to speak to us.
Hey, Mr. Frangakis has not joined yet. He was caught on something else. So we'll play the videos that we've got on the program, give him a couple of minutes, and then if he has not joined yet, we'll go to the next panel. Kostas, can you play the videos, please?
Αθηναίους.
Καλώς.
Πάμε.
Καλώς όρισες.
Hello. Σαν. Ορέστη.
Γρηγόρη. Γεια σου. Άντε, γεια μας. Γεια μας.
This island, it's full of essences. It's amazing. It's a place like in paradise. You have everything. All these scents are my inspiration, especially when I cook here. I am Georgia. I have this restaurant and winery. I'm very proud of my daughter because she takes traditional Cretan cuisine and she turns them into a work of art. She wants to make a different creative cuisine and to evolve my recipes and my mother's recipes, or even my grandmother's recipes. What also makes Cretan cuisine very special is philoxenia. It's part of our culture. You treat other people like they are your family. Like without expecting something from them. With a smile and a good heart. It's from the soul. You can't explain it really.
Pasta. And Cretan pasta for you, sir.
Mr. Frangakis, you are already introduced, and we are very honored to have you with us. So please go ahead and speak to us. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your kind invitation to this Greek gastronomy and diet festival. It's really interesting that you are organizing this kind of event, and I would like to congratulate all of you, and especially Professor Dimitris Bouchalis, who is one of that we're proud to have him. It's an honor for Greece to have a professor in international tourism, and I really would like to congratulate him and thank him for his kind invitation. I am in Crete now. It's my birthplace for some days. You know, Crete is one of the best destinations for gastronomy and diet. It's the island that the Mediterranean diet, or the Cretan diet, as we call it here, was born. And it's one of the best tours that someone can do in order to see, taste, and feel what is to be in Cretan diet. So. In Greek National Tourism Organization, the gastronomy and, of course, diet is one of our priorities. We have a special program for promoting Greek diet and Greek gastronomy abroad. And we're not talking about only the traditional Greek dishes that you all know. We are talking also about gastronomy that it's in high levels for Greece. You know, Greece is not only tzatziki, moussaka, and Greek salad, things that everyone in the world knows. Greece, the last years, has made a huge progress in high level gastronomy, and that's why we are having a program of promoting this kind of gastronomy too abroad. We had a spot, a video spot last year, specialized in gastronomy, and of course we have a program about the combination of diet and wine, because this is also a sector that we made a huge progress the last decade. We also have in our plans the next months to have an agreement with Michelin in Paris in order to launch the Greek Michelin guide. That it's something that the market and Greek tourism need a lot of years now. So I think that in the next months we will be able to have this agreement too. That is very, very important for us. So I would like to once again thank for the invitation. I will stay for a little long in order to hear the other colleagues, and Mr. Bouchalis, Professor Bouchalis, thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you very much, Mr. Frangakis. That completes our opening session. Dimitris, now it's back to you.
Thank you very much, Dean Chon. Thank you very much to the Minister, to Mr. Frangakis, to Mr. Katoulas, and Ms. Papatsoni for joining and supporting from the beginning, because without their support, nothing would have happened. And we were very, very privileged to have all their support throughout the session. Thank you very much, Dean, for chairing the first session.